Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
लॉकडाउन में सब कुछ बदल गया है. बाहर जाना, खाना, शादी ब्याह, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ टाइम एज वी नो इट. एंड आई हैव स्टार्टेड टू वॉच स्कैरी फिल्म्स, बट एट लाइक 7:30 AM, क्योंकि डेयरिंग अभी थोड़ी आई है. Hey guys, my name is Sucharita. This is Film Companion. You're watching Not a Movie Review, and right now I am not going to be reviewing Bulbul.
एक चुड़ैल थी, पेड़ों पे रहती थी.
Set in Bengal in the year 1881, and within 20 years after that, Bulbul is the story of. Wait! Oh my God! Women telling women's stories. It's been so long. So, directed and written by Anvita Dutt, Bulbul is a story of a young girl named Bulbul, married as a child to a man at least 30 years older than her. You follow her into this new life as tiny badi bahu, watch her come of age, learn of the world, and come face to face with the evil residing in it. In the mix is young Satya, the bade thakur's much younger brother, closer in age to Bulbul, who becomes her friend, her confidant, until he sent away to London for higher studies. Bulbul, now alone and rapidly approaching adulthood, is on her own and must figure out ways to survive. जैसा ट्रेलर में भली भांति पता चल गया था देखकर, ये फिल्म हेविली इंस्पायर्ड तो है ही हिंदी माइथोलॉजिकल कहानियों से, पर वो इंस्पिरेशन सिर्फ स्टोरी तक सीमित नहीं है. सिनेमाटोग्राफर सिद्धार्थ दीवान, जिनका स्टेलर काम आपने ट्रैप, भावेश जोशी एटसेट्रा फिल्मों में देखा है, फ्रेम्स ऑलमोस्ट ईच शॉट लाइक एन ओल्ड टाइमी पेंटिंग. ग्रोइंग अप, माय मदर हैड अ कॉपी ऑफ राजा रवि वर्मा'स फेमस नल दमयंती हंग अप इन द लिविंग रूम. अ वुमन लॉन्गिंगली लुकिंग एट अ स्वान who may or may not be her husband. I know very little about that. But I do know that everywhere you look in Bulbul, Siddharth Dewan has tried to replicate a similar aesthetic without making it look dated. Yes, the sets are all very elaborately well set, for which production designer Meenal Agarwal deserves all the credit. But there's also extremely daft camera work at display. In one particularly haunting shot, and I don't mean that literally, a character has been brutally assaulted. She cannot walk because her feet are bleeding. So she's crying and kind of dragging herself on the floor to reach her room. The camera is on the floor at eye level, so we're not looking down and feeling bad about her pain and misery, but instead we're living it with her. We're looking into her eyes. The frame is mostly static, and as soon as she reaches the lens, the camera immediately pulls back, revealing another couple of feet she has to now crawl, and so it goes on, like in a nightmare, when you're running and running and running and still stuck at the same spot. And that's what Anvita Dutt's Bulbul also ultimately is talking about. Less about actual horror stories, but more about the horrific realities which give birth to these stories. Life is a nightmare. थोड़ी रिसर्च करने के लिए निकलो तो चुड़ैल्स के बारे में इतना कुछ है ऑनलाइन टू रीड, टू स्टडी एंड जस्ट बी अमेज्ड बाय स्टफ ऑफ फोकलोर, फेरी टेल्स, कॉशनरी टेल्स कि अंधेरे के बाद घर से बाहर क्यों नहीं जाना चाहिए, एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. तो बुलबुल इज अ यूनिकली इंडियन टेल इन दैट रिगार्ड. व्हेन यू फाइनली सी व्हाट द चुड़ैल इन द फिल्म इज वेयरिंग, यू विल नोटिस दैट शी इज बीन ड्रेस्ड बाय कॉस्ट्यूम डिजाइनर वीरा कपूर ईई एग्जैक्टली लाइक दिस. अ डाकिनी हु इन सम स्टोरीज आर वुमेन हु कम बैक to life under the protection of Kali after being murdered on their wedding night to avenge themselves and other women. This is the folklore. You might spot more symbolism. Bulbul's peacock feather hand fan, a doomsday triggering color changing moon, a forest alive like an actual person, and of course Qaid mein hai Bulbul. But you'll also observe there are various ways in which life is still the same for many women across the country, and the film is saying that to you. Anvita Dutt's film speaks of the need for a sisterhood, and it makes it a point to show you why via many microaggressions. A man returns after 5 years and immediately assumes charge of financial affairs while asking women to cover their heads, judging them for talking to another bloke, and of course, my personal favorite, standing up for all the men ever, popularly known as the bro code. You're meant to notice these moments carefully crafted into this patiently written non-linear screenplay. अच्छा, और इस non-linearity से क्या होता है? Story में suspense generate होता है, अगर ठीक से करो तो. When straight up in the beginning of the film, you're shown that the inner journey of the lead character is complete, and the rest of the film is about finding out how, filling in the gaps, trying to figure what could have potentially led to the current situation. One gets invested in wanting to find out. acting coach Atul Mungia works hard and successfully with the leading actor Tripti Dimri. Bulbul affords her the space to move around, which her debut film Leela Majnu did not. It's a challenging part, and she delivers a confident and a mature performance, especially while playing the teenaged Bulbul. And she carries the majority of the film on her shoulders without a slip up. Avinash Tiwari is a proven stellar actor, and here as well as Satya Thakur, he's clay in his director's hands. In him lies the story's hope. Not as a savior, but as an acknowledger of systemic privilege and harbinger of systemic change. An incredible Rahul Bose plays Thakur with as much ease and perfection with which he transforms into, well, anything I've seen him in. I won't go into too much detail into his role, because it's a neat little surprise hai, jo halanki film ki starting mein dik jayega, but it's fun to find out. Pauli Dham is just excellent as a product of her circumstances, Choti Bahu Binodini. There's a really wonderful scene between her and Bulbul where she's dressing her up like she would a doll, but also just pouring out her grief and deep-seated hurt by regurgitating lines which were probably taught to her as a little girl. The scene starts off as an admonishment, but by the end of it, your heart is aching for this woman who has had to do all kinds of things to be able to survive. Bulbul delivers what it promises, a scary story of a child's imagination come to life in late 19th century India, told via comprehensive filmmaking aimed towards bringing you entertainment. It is not a tough film to decipher, understand, and its themes are easy to grasp. Jo agar miss ho bhi jaye, to a kafi simplistic climax mein sab sundar se aise tie together bhi ho jayega. Kind of like a tumbar light, perhaps. But clean slate films seem to have put their entire might behind finding fun new stories and storytellers and giving them the resources and treatment their ideas deserve. I laud the effort, and I hope Netflix is able to generate enough good buzz around this film so that it reaches maximum people. So on a scale of 1 to 10, Bulbul is 1 hour 34 minutes only, which is a huge blessing because right now attention span is just... Subscribe to Film Companion and come see me on Instagram.